Part 2. Verdant Wind. Garland Moon. The Chaos of War. Claude's plan to call in all Myron forces succeeds, and the Alliance Army captures Fort Mercius. Before they can celebrate their victory, javelins of light rain down from the sky and destroy the fort. Forced to temporarily evacuate, the Alliance Army regroups at Garrig Mach until it is ready to march on Enbar, the Imperial capital.
It's almost time to invade the Imperial capital. We still don't know where Rhea is, but if she's alive, she's likely in Enbar. Hopefully we manage to find her without too much trouble. I know, but if we're not careful, she'll just be whisked away again. I'm sure you must be anxious to see her again. I understand. You need to see Rhea again so you can figure out who you really are. But we're going up against Edelgard here. It won't be so simple.
Our next stop is the Imperial Capital. We've sure come a long way.
What are you talking about? This is Garrig Mach. It's where we started.
I didn't mean literally, Raphael. I was speaking symbolically.
My earnest desire to protect the Alliance has carried me this far. It will not fail me. I am sure the rest of you all have your own reasons to fight as well. Of course, I understand that the fight will not end until we defeat the Empire. And now the time has arrived at long last to march on the Imperial capital and defeat the Emperor.
It really gets you thinking, doesn't it? We all come from different places and have different goals and dreams. But thanks to those two, we were all able to come together and overcome all sorts of challenges.
You are referring to Claude and the Professor, I assume. Even within our own odd group, those two are particularly unusual.
Oh, so you are aware that you're odd.
Well, it was simply a figure of speech. I am speaking about Claude and the Professor right now.
They're like the wind and the trees.
Huh? Claude and the Professor are? What does that even mean? And who is which?
I was just thinking that if we're the birds, then those two are like the trees and the wind. The Professor is a great tree that kindly embraces us and watches over us as we perch on its branches. And Claude is like the wind, pushing us forward as we soar across the open sky.
The metaphor about the Professor is solid, but I think Claude just blows us around on a whim. Still, we owe him a lot.
I think that's beautiful, Marianne. I can really picture it. When this war is over, I'd love to paint a picture of those two. Oh, and of all the people we've fought with as well.
You mean like a historical painting? I like that. Maybe our descendants will look at it a long, long time from now.
I must say, that piques my interest. I look forward to seeing how you portray my valiant efforts.
When you put it that way, we may be witnessing one of the greatest events in Fodlan's history. It's a lot of pressure, but the sense of duty I feel is even stronger than the fear.
I'm just happy to be here with all you. I won't get scared, no matter what we face.
We have our goal. Enbar, the Imperial capital. Let's get to work.
After making preparations at Garrig Mach, the Alliance Army marches to Enbar, the Imperial capital. In response to the Alliance's movements, Emperor Edelgard orders her trusted retainer, Hubert, as well as the Death Knight, to the front lines to meet the Alliance army head-on. The two forces clash in the city streets.
There it is. Enbar, the Imperial capital and the largest city in all of Fodlan.
It's not just big. This city was designed to protect the castle where the Emperor lives. It's as though the city itself is a massive stronghold.
They surely noticed us approaching some time ago, and yet,
Our scouts confirm the citizens haven't been evacuated. They're being kept in town.
I've got to hand it to Her Imperial Majesty. Using her citizens as a shield to protect the castle takes some resolve.
I suspect those mages will be lurking within as well.
Troops deployed to other areas are also returning. If we don't conquer the city quickly, things will get complicated fast.
We can't search until we conquer the city. Let's focus on the fight for now.
Lady Rhea, please be safe.
We've kept the Empire waiting long enough. Onward!
Alright. Time to conquer the town. Where is the Black Knight? Oh, this time he upgraded to a Brave Lance. How cute. As if he needed another reason to double people. Oh, this guy still has the Wood Owl. Hubert still has the Goddess icon. Still has massive magic too. Whoa, why did the rest of my army start here? Oh, I don't like that. Did both Claude and my character start up here? Oh, they did. Oh, okay, well. How are we gonna do this? Well, first of all, I need to see who I'm bringing, so... Alright. I didn't really change much of units that I'm bringing. I think this team is pretty strong by itself. Just that I had to move people around a bit just to make this a bit better for turn one. But yeah, I think we're good to go, so let's just get into it.
We were told Hubert would be leading the enemy forces, but the Death Knight's also with them. We'll have to take care of both of them, but we won't have time to mop up all the enemy units. We'll have to split up and take them on at the same time, or risk being overrun by their reinforcements.
It's here! The Crest of Flames banner! There, on the other side of the canal!
Uninvited guests, I see. Let's ensure they receive a warm welcome. Ready the artillery. Prepare to attack! Rocks, arrows, magic. Rain death upon the enemy until they are silent as the grave. Reinforcements will fly in shortly. Defend the heavy weapons until they arrive.
Alright, so the first thing that sucks a lot is that I can't put Claude or my character here. Because otherwise I would definitely warp in to kill Hubert immediately. But oh well. I'm still planning on warping somebody to kill Hubert though, but I'm gonna have to take care of the Death Knight first. So
shall we?
Perhaps.
We definitely need to get in there. I think I will keep Lawrence instead of everybody's range.
I'll do my best.
Well done.
I'll give these three retribution, since they don't really give me much space to do it.
What's my strategy?
And time to go in. Oof. God damn, that hit rate is horrible. I think I'm better off just letting the Death Knight come to me. Seems like he does move, so I might as well.
Allow me to demonstrate!
All is going to plan.
I'm stronger.
At the ready.
Alright. Meanwhile, I definitely need to kill this guy.
Shall we?
Silver Lance? There we go.
Something wears me out.
There's no stopping me.
I guess Manuela could probably take care of this guy. Oh yeah, Manuela is a bow knight now. I only had like a 30% chance of getting the class, but hey, I got it. Even though I couldn't get Hunter's Volley with her, I think Bow Knight is still like a really decent class anyway.
I've still got hidden talents.
And Manuela's speed growth is so good that she will still get speed here and there. Alright, I'm mainly just killing. Actually, I need to see these guys' reach. Can he get me? Wow, I'm barely outside the range of this. That's convenient. Alright, yeah, Claude. You go ahead and take care of this guy.
Sorry. But I must.
I guess I will keep you at the ready. Oh, is this guy going? Oh, okay. Marianne should be fine. I completely forgot that this guy could go and bonk Marianne. Alright, this group, however.
Probably
my best interest to kill the Armor Knight first. Oh boy.
Let's make this quick.
Guide me well.
I do this for all of us.
Can you kill this guy, Bernie? Oh, that's a kill. But first.
Onward.
Man, that's close. If you had a bit more magic, that would be perfect. I guess Lyseria could probably kill this guy though. Most definitely. What's your speed, big boy? 21. Does Flame have? No, Flame doesn't have enough speed, of course not. That's asking a bit too much of her, unfortunately. Can Seth kill this guy? Yeah, okay, perfect. Then I can send maybe. Actually, can Leonie kill this guy? Yeah, okay. And Seth can probably kill the archer, yeah. Alright, yeah, let's do that. Let's have Flynn kill this guy instead.
Child's play.
See, I can one-shot the Swordmaster with like anything.
You lost that one.
Please don't hit. Thank you.
Alright, who's next?
I didn't know when I get hit by that.
I won't allow it. I can feel it in my bones.
Not a fan of the magic, but, you know, could have been worse. Alright, I do know that these things get crit rate, mainly because of the guy using this is a grappler. So this thing critting Lyseria might be bad. But I guess I have no way to control that right now. Unless I... wait, what's your range? Oh, actually, I can. Because Bernie can smite. There we go.
I've been waiting for you.
Nice touch. Perfect. I can kill the Dead Knight next turn. Well, how you do against the Dead Knight? Because you have a... You have a score to settle with this good knight. I really want to kill her, kill the Dead Knight with her, but... it might be complicated to set up a kill. Actually, that kind of works. What about the Iron Lance? The Iron Lance gives me better void. Oops, sorry. Alright, Dead Knight. Say your prayers, cause you're already dead. Revenge!
To kill, to die, to know one without the other would be maddening.
Manuela finally gets her revenge.
Strength and beauty. What a pair.
Okay, just Hubert left to deal with.
We are taking heavy losses. We need more troops.
Good assist.
All right. I can probably finish this turn, honestly. Because I don't think I need the experience from this map at all. And I already know what the chests have since from the Blue Lions playthrough, so and I already know I don't need those chests. Alright, so I'm pretty sure Leoni can easily destroy the Huber probably. But I don't know if she can get there. That's my main issue right now. Probably pull Icy here. I don't know where. Like, if I rescue here, where are you gonna put Leoni? Actually, what's Huber's speed? Because maybe I'm better off sending Sedan instead. Huber has 15 AS, okay. That's a pretty low avoid too. But just in case, who's more accurate? Leoni? No, Seda is more accurate actually. Alright. We're doing this with Seda then. Come here, brother! Alright, yeah, that's perfect. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8. That is not enough. thing is enough. You do have a... Oh, you don't have the hand axe anymore. Well, actually, check this out. If we give him the march ring, he gets an extra movement. Now we warp him. And boom, bada beam. Just enough movement to get into his range. Oof, 50 damage, Jesus. I should have given you I should have definitely given you a silver axe, honestly. But oh well, it is what it is. Focus strike is and smash. No. Your best bet is honestly the killer axe. Alright, but we aren't doing that yet. First of all, let's see what else we can kill before we finish this.
We're all desperate, aren't we?
I guess in the end I didn't really need retribution. Because I'm ending the map pretty quick, all things considered. Let's see, who can my character go punch? Punch this guy in the face, I guess.
I must lead them well.
And I guess Leone can go. No, not quite. Enough to me. I don't really care about the Wu Dao because nobody in my party is really using physical swords at this point. Alright, Hubert, get ready to say your prayers because you're hopefully dead.
It's almost a shame to kill you. Not even death will make you consequential.
You shall not survive!
We must place our faith in Her Majesty. Her victory is everything.
Well done, everyone. Now we can break through into Anbar. We need to hurry up and attack the palace to block Edelgard's movements. We've made it this far. Somehow. Edelgard is probably looking down on us from somewhere in that castle.
I wonder if she's panicking, or just smiling smugly.
From this point on, she'll be giving it her all, too. Expect her to be tougher than the last time we fought. This battle will settle things once and for all. We'll attack as soon as everyone is ready. Huh? Is that you, Dudu?
I heard the Alliance's army had entered the city. I've been searching for you ever since. I am waiting for a chance to kill Edelgard. I have not yet been blessed with the opportunity.
Well, if you want to fight alongside us, we'd be more than happy to have you.
We fight for different objectives. I swore to offer Edelgard's head to His Highness. But should I fail, I will have no choice but to entrust that mission to you. This is the information I have gathered during my time in hiding here. It includes details about the inside of the castle.
I appreciate this, but what do you plan to do? Don't tell me you plan to go alone.
I've done what I came here to do. Farewell.
Hey! Wait! He's gone. He's just as hard to understand as his liege was. The time has finally come, my friend. Once we win this fight, the Empire will fall. What will become of it? Well, that's for us to decide, isn't it? Odd as it sounds, I believe the forces responsible for destroying Fodlan are also responsible for protecting the livelihood of its citizens. Everything, even the land itself, has been harmed by the chaos of war. Restoring it will be no easy feat. To do that, the first thing we need to think about is a new ruling system for all of Fodlan. As usual, we're on the same page. I was thinking the same thing. Even if the Alliance lords and any remaining influential nobles were to divide up dominion of all of Fodlan, they would simply pursue their own interests. Another war would be inevitable. That's why there needs to be a powerful ruler who stands above them all and unifies Fodlan as one nation. If it means I can lead Fodlan to a better future, I wouldn't mind that at all. My dreams await in a future where Fodlan is no longer ravaged by war. There are things I want to see with you someday. I'll keep thinking about the best way to achieve that goal. Whatever we decide to do, we can't do it until we defeat the Empire. Fodlan can't welcome a new dawn until we win the war. Let's prepare as best we can.
Part 2. Verdant Wind. Garland Moon. Conclusion of the Crossing Roads. On the streets of the Imperial Capital, Alliance forces crush Edelgard's army and take up the perimeter of the Imperial Palace. The time has come to face Emperor Edelgard and to free Rhea from her clutches.
Is everyone ready? The objective of this battle is to defeat Edelgard and rescue Rhea. According to the information Dedu gave us, the throne room is directly north of the castle's main entrance. It's safe to assume that's where Edelgard is. She's a fellow student to all of us. If there's a path that we can walk together, that would be preferable. But that all depends on Edelgard. If she won't yield, then that's that. If showing pity would put my allies in danger, I will not hesitate to kill her. I ask that you and everyone here prepare yourselves to do the same.
Understood. I think I speak for everyone when I say that we are prepared.
The future of the Alliance. No, of Fodlan is at stake. I have been prepared for this my whole life.
Captain Gerald taught me that indecisiveness is a weakness. One must cast aside their doubts before fighting.
The lives of Lady Rhea and everyone here are more important than all else. I shall be prepared.
You know what? I wouldn't be surprised if she took one look at my overstuffed muscles and surrendered in tears then and there.
I really hope that Edelgard will yield.
Edelgard is a stubborn one. I don't think she's likely to surrender.
Goddess, please protect us.
I'll fight with all I've got to save Lady Rhea.
Rescuing Lady Rhea is my dearest wish. We must prevail no matter what it takes.
In the name of the Knights of Seros, we'll bring the hammer down on the Imperial Army.
Satisfied yet, boy? Everyone made up their minds a long time ago.
Okay, let's get started. We're yours to command, my friend.
Everyone, take your positions. The battle is upon us.
All right, well. Oh God, I don't wanna fight that. There is Edelgard. She looks less impressive than Petra, that's for sure. Honestly, considering the starting positions, oh, hey, Dorothea. Do you have Dorky? Wow, you have Alert 10 plus too? Okay then. We have the big dudes as well. Honestly, considering the starting positions, this seems like a map you can cheese. So, let's see who will be ringing for the cheese. Alright, so much like before, there wasn't really much that I needed to change, per se. Because I think we're just gonna cheese this map with warp. Although, unfortunately, my character... I might need to change my character to a flying class. Because I don't think I can get in there. Unless... Actually, I'm pretty sure my character can one round Edelgard. Actually, let's see how can we work this out.
They've made it into the palace, but it's actually the perfect chance to turn the tables on them. Defeating them all will turn the tide of war instantly. Taking a risk on dragging us back from the brink is the only option. Everyone, prepare for a bitter struggle. Victory to the Adrestian Empire!
There are more enemies inside the palace than I thought. It's gonna take a lot to bring this situation under control. But if we defeat Edelgard, then victory is ours. Everyone, let's go! Our bashful little emperor has locked herself up behind the door of the throne room. The key should be around here somewhere. We need to find whoever's got it and take them out.
Shall we?
Alright, so first of all, we're gonna give everybody, or most people, stride. And let's see, what's your warp range, Lycidia? Hopefully it's really good. Sounds pretty good. What's my movement with stride and the march ring? 14. Yeah, 14 should be enough. Too bad I don't have pass, so what I'm gonna have to do is... Because I wanna see the dialogue between Claude and Edelgard and my character and Edelgard. So I think I'm gonna have to attack with Claude first. Then rewind time, kill this girl, and then have my character go kill Edelgard. That's pretty much what I wanna do, pretty much. This is the reason why my,
What's my strategy?
Why my character also... Oh, also why I made Lycidia Grimoire. Just so I could have a
apologies.
Double warp. Alright, well.
At the ready.
And just in case Claude decides to kill Edelgard, we're gonna gambit her.
Your ideals. I understand they're not so far removed from my own. But without sufficient knowledge of this land's suffering, I can't entrust Fodlin to you.
Perhaps. I dare say it's true that I don't fully understand the history of Fodlin. Still, I've seen many things in my life. Don't worry. I'll finish the job for you. Good time for a secret scheme.
We got the dialogue. Also, since I did play the Violet solo on the church route, I'm pretty sure this should be the same, but the dude is gonna spawn here and try to distract these guys. He's not gonna get a chance to do it on this playthrough, because we're gonna kill Edelgard right now.
There's no stopping.
So I guess before we do that, I guess I am kind of curious if
I do this for all of us.
Dorothea has anything to say. I don't think I actually. Does Manuela have a dialogue with Dorothea?
Manuela? It's not like you to show up anywhere sober. What's the occasion?
I thought maybe we could talk. I could help you see the error of your ways. Or we could just try to kill each other over what we believe in. You ready to do this?
No. But let's get to it. Edelgard, forgive me. I can't.
Sorry, my blue lion's waifu. I had to do it. For the dialogue.
This should give us a bit more freedom of movement. Now, how best to attack?
Yeah, I had a feeling Manuela was gonna have a dialogue with Dorothea, so. I don't know if Petra will have a dialogue with anybody. Maybe Bernie? I don't know.
I can't be letting you pass. I will defend, and I will be killing all of you. We must be... must clear the way forward. For every person. No use!
Well, that answers my question. So I guess we're not killing Petra, because that evasion, that's some evasion she got. Alright, I guess I'll try to kill somebody. Oh jeez. Oh, did I not equip Tempest Lance on her? Yes, I did not. Well, whatever. Doesn't really matter if she gets hit.
Can't afford to slack off.
Ooh, nice.
I still have a long way to go. I'll try.
I'm guessing these chests have the same thing as they do in Blue Lions too, so. I mean, they have good shit, don't get me wrong, but... Wow, 27 avoid against magic too. Oof. Goddamn, Petra. Why are you so fucking scary? Nice level.
I feel my strength building.
Good stuff, Link. Good stuff.
You're relentless.
My orders? I'm not dying here.
Guide me well.
Oh, you know what? I'm kinda curious if Senet had a dialogue with her too. Oh man, but I guess I will have to redo way too much. Well, not way too much, but...
I won't allow it.
I don't feel like hearing Dorothea cry for me again.
At the ready.
Alright, Claude. Clear the way, because I need to kill Edelgard.
A fitting outcome.
Oh my god.
The weak fall, the strong live.
That's a good level.
What's my strategy?
My strategy is to go in and punch some shit.
Professor, I suppose you think you can defeat me, is that right? But I will never give up. Even if my arms and legs failed me, I would still find a way to move forward. I will smash that false goddess and her minion into the ground. I will fight to free this world from her vile grasp.
Here is something to believe in!
If you do not act now, this conflict will go on forever. Your path lies across my grave. It is time for you to find the courage to walk it. If I must fall, let it be by your hand. With you.
It's over. We were only able to beat her because of you. This wasn't the conclusion I had hoped for, even though I... Never mind. It's over now. The important thing is that we won.
Here, boy. A letter. An Imperial General asked me to give it to you.
A letter? Let's see it. It looks like it's from Hubert, Edelgard's vassal.
If you are reading this letter, that means I have perished. As Her Majesty would never surrender to another, I can only assume she has fallen as well. It greatly pains me to think of this coming to pass. That said, as the survivors, I must ask you to settle certain affairs in our stead. You must destroy the threat that slithers in the dark. I am sure you must recall Monica and Tomas. Their allies yet live. They hold deep resentment against the children of the goddess and the people of the world. And they are biding their time until they can exact revenge. If left to their own devices, it is certain they will eventually bring unimaginable calamity and suffering to the world. I detected their sorcery when you took Fort Mercius. I have deduced the location of their stronghold, Shambhala. You will find its whereabouts enclosed. There is no question that they are the enemies of everyone in Fodlan. Do not allow yourselves to forget that. Lastly, while I cannot say she is in good health, the Archbishop resides in a secret chamber in the Imperial Palace. I have shared the location of the entrance to that secret chamber with the person to whom I have entrusted this letter. I believe that Her Majesty will be victorious. Even still, I must plan for her defeat as well. If you wish to lead this world, I challenge you to rise to the occasion and surpass my estimation of you. Such is your obligation as the victors. And the only fitting tribute to all that Lady Edelgard sacrificed.
Hubert, to leave a letter like this behind, you were a better man than I believed you to be. So, Rhea is alive, and the fight isn't over yet. Those who slither in the dark. It sounds like Fodlan will never know peace unless we defeat them.
The allies of Monica and Tomas. Well, we knew about them already. I think it's safe to assume this is the same group who used Lysithia for their blood experiments. And they were also responsible for the Javelins of Light that destroyed the fortress. But who are these children of the goddess who they supposedly resent? There's just not enough information here. I don't suppose there's any chance that this is his idea of a prank. If so, well, good one. Hubert, rather than writing a letter, you should have just told us before we fought. Right. We still don't know for sure if this letter is telling the truth. Let's go find out.
You have come to save me. Is this a dream? I have longed to see you again, all this time. Is it truly you?
Claude, I can see you have grown into a reliable young man. Thank you for supporting the professor and for rescuing me. Surely the protection of the goddess has...
Wait, Rhea. What do you know about the children of the goddess?
Children of... What is this about?
Forgive my bluntness. Someone from the Empire filled us in on a few things. I know it must be painful for us to ask you difficult questions after such an arduous confinement. But we have no choice. We must defeat a secret enemy. Those who slither in the dark. Do you know about them?
Those who slither in the dark?
Apparently, they resent the children of the goddess and the people of the world, and are planning something big, something terrible. They use blood for their wicked magic and are capable of dropping javelins of light from the sky, which are powerful enough to crush a fortress. If you can think of anything at all, please tell us now. We need to know as much as possible about these enemies in order to stop them. This is the critical moment that will determine whether or not Fodlan falls. Can't you see that the time for secrets has passed?
It is true that there is a group of people who have slithered in the darkness and threatened the peace of Fodlan since ancient times. I am sure you have heard the stories of a man named Nemesis.
Nemesis, the King of Liberation. He's the hero to whom the goddess gave the Sword of the Creator.
Nemesis was originally the leader of a group of bandits. He plundered the holy tomb and stole the remains of the progenitor god. When Nemesis appeared in Xanadu some time later, he already wielded the Sword of the Creator.
Xanadu, the Red Canyon.
I do not know how Nemesis obtained the sword, or why he appeared in Xanadu, but he used that sword to massacre the people there, the children of the progenitor god. From their corpses, he gained even more power and brought war to Fodlan.
That's completely different from what the legends tell us about Nemesis.
A mere bandit like Nemesis would not have been capable of anything so monstrous on his own.
Aha! So Nemesis had accomplices. And those accomplices must have been those who slither in the dark. They used Nemesis. And this time, they used the Imperial Army to once again bring war to Fodlan. I finally get it. And I even understand why Edelgard was associating with them. Just as they were trying to use the Empire was trying to use them. Rhea, there's still a mountain of things I need to ask you. And I will. But I'll leave all of that for another day. You must be weak after living in confinement for so long. Please, rest for a while. My friend, let's prepare for battle. We need to strike Shambhala as soon as possible.
You must not allow Fodlan's bloody history, the Red Canyon tragedy, to repeat itself.
It occurs to me that we never got an answer from Rhea about the children of the goddess. She did say that the people of the Red Canyon were the children of the progenitor god, so I suppose so. But those evil guys continued to plot their revenge even after the Red Canyon tragedy. Does that mean some of the children of the goddess or their descendants are still alive? Could be. She was talking about what happened in Xanadu as if she was there herself. What are these children anyway? And how are they connected to the goddess? Ah, I almost disappeared into the bottomless swamp that is my mind. I thought that after we defeated the Empire, I'd be able to see that sight I longed to see. I've told you about my dreams before. I want to break down the wall separating Fodlan from the outside world. The sight I want to see lies beyond that. Honestly, it's a trivial thing to fixate on. Just people, gathered in their towns, living out their lives together, sometimes laughing, sometimes fighting. But the people living there aren't just citizens of Fodlan. There are people from Dagda, Bridget, and even Dusker and Srang. There could be people who were born in Almira, or countries even farther east there, too. All of those people living together like it's nothing special at all. That's the sight I long to see. It's so simple, but still so far away. But this is no time for complaining. We need to focus on capturing Shambhala. Let's hurry up and gather everyone together.
So, you mean to tell me that Fodlan will fall to ruin if we leave those guys be?
If this map is reliable, their base is just south of my family's territory.
This story is a bit much to believe. And yet...
it does ring true, somehow.
Remember Monica, the one who killed Geralt, and the old man who was masquerading as Tomas? They were their allies, and the Flame Emperor and the Death Knight were merely their pawns.
The people who were after my blood?
They were also the ones who used me to conduct their blood experiments.
As awful as it sounds, they're seemingly fond of using blood in their secret techniques.
Ugh, that's really gross. I could never be friends with someone like that.
I believe they were also responsible for the Javelin of Light that destroyed Fort Mercies.
Hold up, boy. Do you really think that we can win against such powerful foes?
I don't know. But we have to try, don't we?
Since Edelgard can't do it, I guess it falls to us.
They were trying to use the Imperial Army to plunge Fodlan into war, but we nipped that in the bud. Now we just need to tear out their roots. And I know we have what it takes to do it.